Hey guys and girls, so this time I'm going to be taking a look at the process of inside out wood turning. Now this is something that I've actually never done myself, so we're going to have to see how it goes. But I'm going to be turning this little heart pendant, which I guess you could give as a Valentine's Day gift. Yeah, okay. So I've got these two little strips of wood here, and I'm just going to start out by joining them together temporarily using some screws. And I've just taped over where these screws are so I know to avoid them when I've got it on the lathe. And now I'm just mounting it between centres on the lathe. So the first step to inside out turning is to turn the inside shape which you want to achieve. You can see I've marked on with a pencil half the shape of the heart. Now I won't actually be able to see this when I'm turning, but when I turn the lathe off periodically I'll be able to see what progress I've made and where I need to remove some more material. And once I'd roughly achieved the inside shape which I wanted, I followed up with a bit of sanding to smooth it out. So with the two parts unscrewed now, I can flip them around and you can see how the heart comes together. Now, taking a look at this, I would like the centre of this to be slightly pointier. Now what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to take it over to the jointer and just take a couple of light passes on each side of the heart, and that way I should get a slightly better appearance. So with that done, the heart actually comes together much nicer than it did before. So all I've got to do next is glue the two pieces together, and then I'll be ready to put it back up on the lathe once it's dry. And now that's dried, I'm mounting it back onto the lathe using a chuck, and I will of course bring up the tailstock for some extra support. With it mounted to the lathe, I can go ahead and turn the outside profile, which of course in this case is the same as the inside which I turned, but you could of course do some very different outside shaping, and this would give a completely different appearance to the turning. So at this point the turning is pretty much done now. I had initially intended on turning the top of the heart on the lathe, which is why I mounted it in a chuck, but it was getting to the stage where it was just too fragile to continue turning, so I decided to cut my losses and stop there. Just before I removed it from the lathe, however, I finished off with a bit of sanding. And over here at the bandsaw, I'm just cutting off the waste material around the heart. Over here at the drill press, I'm using a drum sanding attachment to shape a tip onto the end of the heart. Now I'm just using some files and some sandpaper to shape the top of the heart. So to make this heart into a pendant, I'm just going to glue in this little eyelet which I twisted out of some galvanized wire, and I'm just going to glue that into this hole which I've drilled with a little tiny bit of epoxy. And I'm just finishing off this pendant with a few coats of finishing oil. Then of course the final touch is to stick this pendant onto a chain. Right, so that's inside out wood turning for you. Now this heart pendant didn't turn out too badly at all really. It's certainly not the best wood turning I've ever done, but it still is quite nice. And my sister actually took quite a shine to it, so at least it will get some use. And it did also outline the principles of inside out wood turning quite nicely really. Now if you are thinking about doing some inside out wood turning, I suggest just heading over to Google Images. There's going to be a load of great bits of inspiration on there for you to do some inside out wood turning. Another really good idea is to take four pieces of square stock and joining those together to do your initial turning, and then flipping them all around and gluing those together, and that will also give a really great effect. I know it'll definitely be something that I will be revisiting, but however, for now, have fun with that, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.